not what you think. Please, let me explain.
I'm sure you have an explanation, Ethan. You always have an explanation. You know, I really don't want to hear it this time. You know, I don't ever want to hear your voice or see your face
ever again, for that matter.
Just please, listen to me.
I'm through being played for a fool, Ethan.
Gwen, now listen.
Wait, let me explain. I'll tell you what's really going on. I know how this looks, Gwen, but Ethan's telling the truth. Nothing is going on.
Really?
We were just sleeping.
Oh, was that all, Teresa?
Yes, that's all.
The heat and electricity went out, and we were just trying to stay warm.
Oh, and I bet you kept each other quite warm. Probably pretty hot, right, Teresa? Especially with Ethan's arm around you.
Gwen, I didn't even know my arm was around her. I was dreaming.
Ethan, if you wanted to break up with me, you could have at least had the decency to do it instead of planning this little rendezvous with Teresa.
I didn't plan anything.
He didn't even know I was coming up.
Then what the hell are you doing here, Teresa?
I'm trying some papers for him to sign.
Papers, really?
She's right. I mean, it's only because of business that she's
business,
here.
Business, yeah, and I bet I know what kind of business.
Gwen, it's true.
Really? Then how is it that she got up here before me? Because all the roads have been closed because of the snowstorm.
I got here before the storm closed the roads.
Before? That means that Teresa was here when I was on the phone with you? You mean to tell me, while I was telling you how worried I was about you up here all by yourself, she was here with you? I don't believe you, Ethan. You led me to believe that you were here all by yourself waiting for me when all the time Teresa was here with you? No wonder you wanted me to turn around and go home. What did you tell me, Ethan, that you were so worried about me being out in the storm all by myself? You didn't want anything to happen to me? No, what you didn't want was for me to come up here and find you in bed with Teresa.
Listen to me.
You lied to me, Ethan.
Gwen,
you led me to believe you were up here by yourself. That is the same thing as a lie. How many other lies have you told me, Ethan? How many?
None. I've never lied to you. I swear. I love you.
Don't you dare touch me.
Gwen.
You shut up.
You have no right to be mad at Ethan.
How dare you tell me how to feel, Teresa?
None of this is his fault. He didn't even know I was coming up here.
Really?
It's true. He was expecting you. Yeah, this whole cabin did up just for you. He had little love notes leading up into the bedroom.
Teresa.
There were candles burning and rose petals on the bed. And he wanted to surprise you by jumping out and being naked and kissing you, practically taking you to the bed.
Naked? Now, how do you know all this, Teresa? Did Ethan discuss all of his romantic plans with you?
I only know this because that's how he greeted me when I walked in.
Excuse me? Ethan kissed you? Naked, Ethan?
Gwen,
you kissed Teresa naked?
I thought she was you. That's the only
reason. Oh, sure. Because we look so much alike. I mean, I'm a blonde, she's a brunette.
Look, it was dark. I was expecting you, not her.
Gwen, don't be mad. If you could have seen what Ethan had planned for you, the caviar, the champagne, the oysters, they were wonderful. I mean,
you and Teresa ate the dinner that you and I were supposed to have?
We had to eat.
No, I have heard enough, Ethan.
I swear to you, Gwen, I had no idea she was coming here.
Mr. Crane was supposed to call and tell Ethan that he sent me up here with the papers, but he didn't.
Your father sent her up here?
Yes, he had some important business papers I needed to sign.
Tell me? There's nothing to tell, Father. Teresa and I don't have a sexual relationship. We don't have any kind of relationship.
All right, I can understand if you'd rather not talk about it with your old man. But you're a hot-blooded young man. I mean, I can't believe you haven't noticed the body on that girl. She's incredible looking.
Well, yes, she's very beautiful.
So if you haven't taken her to bed, you have to admit it's crossed your mind, hasn't it?
Convenient.
Gwen, she just brought up the papers to get my signature, and then she was to leave.
And why didn't she leave?
Look, I called her a cab to take her to the train station, but it broke down on the way here. Then I tried to take her myself, but the car battery went dead. And it was snowing like crazy, and then the electricity and the heat went off.
The fire was all the heat we had in the cabin.
Oh, not to mention all the heat you two generated all snuggled up with each other, right, Teresa?
Gwen, nothing happened. It was completely innocent.
If it was so innocent, why didn't you tell me she was here when I was on the phone?
I should have, but...
You know what? I don't even want to hear the lies, Ethan.
I'm not lying.
You know, I don't want to hear any of it. All of these little innocent encounters with Teresa have been one too many, and I am tired of it. I'm out of here.
Look, Gwen, please, don't leave yet.
Let me explain to you.
Can you imagine, Whitney? Snowed in with Ethan?
And Gwen found you asleep together in front of the fire.
With Ethan's arm around me.
And she didn't call your eyes out?
What would be the point? Deep down, she knows there's nothing she can do. Ethan's fallen for me.
Gwen?
Go back inside, Ethan. You're gonna catch pneumonia.
Look, I don't care. You have to believe me. This is a misunderstanding.
It's always a misunderstanding with you, Ethan. Look, I bought her the first time. I even let it go the second time, but this is ridiculous.
Gwen, please.
No, don't. Don't.
Gwen, you mean everything to me. You are the only woman I love. You are the only woman I want. And you have to believe me.
I don't you think I want to.
Then do.
Even a relationship is nothing without trust. I thought I could trust you. But something was broken tonight. Something I don't think can ever be fixed.
Don't say that. You can trust me.
If I could trust you, why didn't you tell me Teresa was here when I called?
I didn't want you to get upset.
What else haven't you told me because you didn't want me to be upset? Would I have ever found out that you kissed Teresa if she hadn't blurted it out?
I told you, I thought she was you.
How many times have you kissed me over the years, Ethan? Hundreds? Thousands? How could you possibly kiss her and think she was me? No, there's something else going on here.
No, there is.
With her, there is, Ethan. I told you she's in love with you, and now to find you two up here alone?
My father sent her up here, and then we got snowed in.